So as IFOA has announced that all its exams will be conducted in the MS Word and we will have to type down our answers of paper A for CS1, CM1 and CM2 and CM1 in Word and have to submit this Word file to the IFOA. Now I will be taking a look at some quick shortcuts and some features which will improve efficiency in our exams so that we can type easily and it may increase our typing speed. So here are some quick shortcuts. Basic ones are Control S, which is save. So what I would suggest is that whenever we are typing our answers down, it is really it might so happen that our computer or our PCs turns off due to any technical issues. So it's very important you keep saving your work. So after every answer, just click on Control S and it will save your work. As you can see, it will save your work, right? Control Z is for undo. Suppose I conduct whatever I have done in my previous step and I just click on Control Z, it will simply undo my previous work. Control O is for open. To open a new Word document, you just have to click on Control O and it will open. You can just simply search for your documents and you can open that particular document you want to. Control P is for print, which is not so much of use for us now. Control X is for cut. Suppose you want to cut this and paste it somewhere else, so you just click on Control X and this will cut whatever the selection you have done. Control V is then for paste. Control C is similarly for copy, so I can just simply copy this and if I want to paste it again, I will just click on Control V to paste it again, right? So Control V and you can paste it again. So these are the very quick shortcuts. Control B is for bold, so if you want to change it into bold, you just have to click on Control B and you change everything to bold. Again, to unbold it, you can just click on Control B again. So moving on, this is for italics, so you can just simply select everything and just Control I will change it into italics. Control I. So why I am specifying on these is because it might so happen in our answers there are some keywords which we want to highlight, so it's better that we use bold. We can just simply do Control B and we can bold those keywords which we want to highlight, or we can change it into italics by using Control I, or we can underline those keywords using Control U. So that will underline my keywords. Also over here in the home tab, you will see in the font section there are many editing tools which you can see. For us, for the time being, we do not have to use so much of editing tools because obviously we need to increase our speed by typing our answers. So again, now this is Control bracket, and Control bracket is for decreasing the font by 1 point. So when I click on Control bracket, you can see it decreased my font size. Similarly, to increase the font size, Control closing bracket and it will increase my font size by 1 point. To clear all the formatting, you'll just have to click on Control spacebar. Suppose you have formatted a particular section, you have changed it into bold, italics, underline, whatever it may be, or you have changed the color of that particular font. So when you want to clear all the formatting for at once, you just have to click on Control spacebar and see, it clears all the formatting off. Also, then we have repeat the last action. Suppose you have done a particular action and you want to repeat that again, so you have to click on F4 and it will just simply repeat all that particular action again. So I'll just click on F4 and it will just repeat all the last actions again. Then we have F12 to save as. Suppose you are creating a new Word document and you want to save it, so you just have to click on F12. A dialog box will open up, a window will open up, and in this window you can just select wherever you want to save your work, change the file name, and you can just simply save your work, right? Shift F3 is for font case. Then we have, this is for changing the font case. So basically shift F3 will change it to, see, it turned it into all caps lock. Shift F3, it will change it into all small letters. Shift F3, it will change it into a proper case. So basically, when you click on this, you have these different cases over here. Sentence case. So this is a sentence case. Lowercase, when all the letters are in lowercase, you have uppercase, you have capitalize each word, and you have toggle case. So if I click on Control Shift F, Shift F3 again, it will change it into uppercase. Shift F3, small case. Shift F3, the sentence case, right? So this can also be done if you want to change all the letters to caps lock at once. So what do you do? You just select all those words in to which you want to change it into caps lock, and you just click on Control Shift F3 will change it into caps lock. Okay, moving on, rotate through four edit location. So when I click on Shift F3, you see it went to the previous location where I was editing my document. Shift F5 again, I was here in the last place when I was editing. Shift F5, and this is how it will move through four last edit locations. So when you have completed your entire document, and suppose you want to go to the last location where you were doing your editing, then you can just click on Shift F5 to just simply rotate through the edit locations. We have thesaurus. For that, you just have to click on Shift F7. Basically, it's like a dictionary which you can just simply search for your words. So if I search for any particular word over here, you can get your answer from it. But I would not suggest you all to do this during the examination, because this is prohibited by the IFA. Now when you want to go to the beginning of any line, suppose you are writing your answer and you want to go to the beginning of that particular line, you just have to click on home button like here will take you to the beginning of that line. To move to the end of the line, you just have to click on the end button, and the end button, you will just click on the end button and it will take you to the end of the line. Similarly, to move to the beginning of the document, we click on Control Home. Control Home will take me to the beginning of the document. Control Home, see, it will take me to the beginning of the document. Then you click on Control End. Control End will take you to the very last of your document. So Control Home to the very beginning, Control End to the very last of the document. And obviously end will take it to the end of the line. So what are the important shortcuts which we learned? The very important one is the Control S to save your work again and again. As soon as you complete one answer, click on Control S, it will simply save your work so that you do not lose it, even if your PC turns off due to any technical issues. Then the other features, Control Z is for undo, to undo any previous action, previous word which you have written. Then we have all these, which is Control Bold, Control I for italics, U for underline. These are for the basic highlighting of your answers, highlighting the keywords in your answers. Next is Shift F3, which is basically to change the font case to upper, lower, or sentence case if you want to. Again, to highlight those keywords if you want to keep it in caps locks. Then we have to move to the very beginning of the line, to the end of the line, end of the document, and beginning of the document. So these are again the keywords which you need to make sure you know. Key shortcuts which you should know. So these were the quick basic shortcuts. Now moving on, the next feature which you might find helpful is the find and replace. Suppose you want to replace certain word which you have written. So what you can do is you can just simply, in the home tab, you will see editing group. In this you have find and replace, or you can use the shortcut Control F. So I will just click on Control F, and this will give me the find navigation button dialog box over here. You can find for any word if you want to. You'll just have to click, suppose I'm clicking on home, and see, it will get me through the word home. If you want to replace any word, you just have to click on the shortcut Control H, or in the home tab you have this replace over here. So Control H is basically, suppose you want to replace home with some other word, so you can do that and you can click on replace all for replacing all the words home with certain different word you want to. Okay, now we are quickly going through as to what we have to do in our exam so that it we increase our efficiency and increase our speed during the examination. Now, as I've told in my previous videos, we just have to follow the notations given by the IFOA. We do not have to use the equation editor. So IFOA has stated very, very clearly in all its documents that they do not expect students to know to learn the equation editor. The use of equation editor is what IFOA has stated, that they do not want their students to do that, use that or learn that. So we have completely ignored and minimized the use of equation editor. So basically this is what IFOA has stated us to completely ignore the use of equation editor. So we'll be only concentrating on the notations given by the IFOA. Secondly, also what many students are facing an issue or maybe having a doubt, that can we use Excel, can we write things in Excel, or we can we calculate, do our workings in Excel, and can we copy paste it in Word? So no, that is also not allowed. You cannot do your workings in Excel and you cannot do your calculations in Excel and simply copy paste that in Word. You will have to only use Word. So for simplicity, for ease of the usage and how to increase the speed and efficiency, I would only suggest you all to only use the MS Word. Do not use anything else, because once you start using Excel, what will happen, you will again and again type things in Word and type things in Excel, and you will have to again and again copy paste that into your Word document, which becomes really confusing. Also, you will be having second thoughts as to, should I copy paste this into Word? Is this acceptable? So all these confusion, to avoid these confusions, it's better that we restrict only to Word document. We do not focus on Excel, because everything can be done on Word without usage of Excel. So when I say everything can be done in Word, I mean that all of the answers when we are going to write in our Word documents, many and most of it and all of it can be done in Word without the use of Excel itself. So suppose the very first question is how to insert a table. So it's very simple, just go to the insert tab over here. We have the tables section. Simply click on the table, select the number of rows and columns you want to create. Suppose I want to create 3 columns, and it may so happen I do not know the number of rows I will require in my answer. So just create 2-3 rows, click on it and see, it gets inserted straight away. Then you just have to simply type everything, whatever you want to. Suppose this is the x values which I want, so I will just simply write x values. Then to move to the next cell, just click on the right arrow, or you can click on the tab button, and over here we have, suppose, the observed values, right? Again clicking on the tab button or the right button, here we have the expected values, so something like that. And then just click on tab and you move on to the next row. So if you want to create one more, if you want to add one more row to this, how will you add it? Just simply click on tab. The moment you click on tab, you will move on to the next row. See, you will add new rows like this to your table. If you want to delete any row, simply select that particular row, click on backspace, it will ask you whether you want to delete it or not, click on OK. When you want to delete a particular column, again select that particular column, click on delete, and then it will simply delete, or click on backspace and it will simply delete that particular column or the row. So this is how you simply create tables in Excel. Go through 5 or 6 examiners report and they have shown as to what all are the workings which are required. So it becomes easier for you to know that how will be the marks given to each working which you show. Do not show extra workings, but also at the same time show all those workings which are necessary and which will get you marks. But if you skip any workings in between, it may so happen you will lose one or two marks, which is not good, right? Because each working, each line carries certain marks for IFO examinations. Moving on, the next thing is that the next very, very important tip is that write each answer in one page. Suppose I am writing answer 1 over here. Suppose this is my answer 1. So what I'll do is I will move on to the next page. Let me just move on to the next page. I'll just simply click on enter. Click on enter and you move on to the next page over here. Suppose this is my new page. I will write in bolds, make it in bolds. So control P, answer 1. Suppose this is my answer 1. I'm starting with answer 1. And then just simply click on enter. Control B, control U, and you can see you remove everything, all the editing. And then start typing your answer from here. So this will make your presentation really neat. Also, when you go back and when you want to change or want to review your answer, it will become easier for you all also to know where your answers are. Suppose I complete my answer and it gets completed till here, maybe half a page. I move on to the next question, next answer. For the next answer also, give it a new page. Start writing it from here. Start writing it from here. Start writing answer again, answer 2. So this is how you start typing your answer. Even if it took half a page, doesn't matter. Move on to the next question in the new page. But if it is an MCQ type of an answer, in case of an MCQ, they just require your answer number. That is whether it's A, B, C, D, nothing else. They will just simply ignore all the workings you do. Even if you think that let me just do some working so I will get some extra marks, it may so happen my answer is wrong but my workings are correct, so I will get my marks, some of my marks. No, they will just simply ignore your workings for MCQ type of questions. So in this case, what do you need to do? You just have to simply write over here answer and whatever part your answer is of. Suppose you'll just simply write over here answer and then maybe it's A, so you'll just give option A. That's it. If you want to give the value, you can do that. Suppose option A is 116, suppose for example. So you can just simply write 116, but that is also not necessary. They will just ask for the option number. So you give A. If you want to change it in bold, you can simply change it in bold by using the shortcut control B so that you can highlight the option. Nothing else. If it's of 3 marks, you will get your 3 marks. If it's of 4 marks, you will get your 4 marks if the option is correct. All your workings will be simply ignored. Even if you do a lot of working, no point, ignore it. They will just simply ignore it. Also, second point, if you mention 2 options, suppose you are confused and it might so happen. Some of the students do that. They mention two options, like they just give comma and they mention this really happens. They give 2 options. So this is also, they will just simply give you a 0. Even if A is correct, they will give you a 0. Even if B is correct, they will give you a 0, because they just want one answer, one option number, no workings, nothing, just an option number. So this is how you type an MCQ type of a question. Simply write answer and give the option number, A, B, C, D, whatever it is. Okay, really simple. Moving on, the next thing is how to write a superscript, subscript. So they have told us that suppose we have KX, so we write K and then what we do is K underscore X. So this is how we write K underscore X, KX. You can use superscript and subscript, but that is what they do not want actually. They just want you all to show it this way. If there is something K square, if you want to write K square, you just write K, you give this caret symbol and you write 2. So this will give you, as I've told in my previous videos as well, this is how you give your superscript or K square, but something if there is only in the superscript that is not in par. Suppose I want to write KE, where E is maybe for expectation or anything sort of like that, but that does not signify your par. That does not signify K to the par E. Basically, it's K sub superscript E. So in that case, what do? You just write K within the bracket, you write E. Within the bracket, you write E. This does not mean it's K to the power E. This means that it is K in the superscript, you have E. Also, what you can do, you can use these also. Suppose you want to write K, X, you use this subscript and just write X. Again, just click on the subscript to move back to the normal. You can use the shortcut if you want to. What is the shortcut key? The shortcut key is Control equal to sign. So Control equal to C. Control equal to you move to the subscript, just type in whatever you want to. Control equal to, again back to the normal. Suppose for similarly for the superscript K, I want to write E in the superscript. Control shift plus, so this is the shortcut. Control shift plus and you write your E, again Control shift plus, move back to the normal. So this was your superscript, subscript, how to write MCQ questions. Difference between to the power and superscript, so there is a difference. K, E, this only means that E is in power. That does not mean that it is K square or K to the power E. This means it is K square, K to the power 2, right? There is a difference between both. Moving on, the next thing is very important, is the auto text feature. Suppose I write a word. Let me again use this K underscore X only. If I write K underscore X, I get this error or the red line. Many place you will see red lines, many place you will see blue lines. Blue lines is for grammatical mistakes which you make. Red lines is for the spelling errors which Excel, which Word considers that okay, this has been a spelling mistake maybe. But I know, no, this is correct. You do not have to remove this because it's fine. It's simply fine. You have written everything correctly. But if you want to turn these red and blue lines off, what do? You just click on File. You go to the Options. In the Options, you have Proofing. Click on Proofing. Here you will see many features. Like some of here are Check Spelling as you type. So when you untick this, it will not check the spelling mistakes. So you will not get your red lines. Mark grammar errors as you type. So you will not get those blue lines if you untick this, right? Also what you can do is, suppose only for this document I want to do this. I do not want to do this for all my Word documents. So I use this exceptions for useful shortcuts. Basically, this is the name which I have given to my Word document. And I'll just simply click on hide spelling errors and hide grammatical errors. This will only happen in this particular document. And when I open a new Word file, I will still get my spelling mistakes and I will still get those red and blue lines. But if you want to turn it off for all the Word documents, so that whenever you open a new Word document, you do not get any such kind of lines, you just simply untick these two buttons over here, right? Also, in the autocorrect options over here, we have something as show the autocorrect option button. So this is basically the option which you get when you have any spelling mistake. There is a small box which appears on the right hand side. You might have noticed that, and that asks you, that gives you various options. Suppose you have made a spelling mistake, so that gives you the correct spelling, or maybe it asks you whether you want to add the word to the dictionary, or whether you want to ignore that particular error. So all those options which you get, that small box which you get on the right hand side, if you want to remove that box, if you do not want to get that box again and again, you can untick this as well. So it will not show you that options button, autocorrect options button. Even if your spellings are wrong, it will just give you that red line, but it will not give you that option to change it or maybe to correct it. It will not give you the correct spelling or all those options which you get. Now there is something as replace text as you type. This I do not want you all to use, but just to know that you can have, you can write certain words and you can replace it with something else. So that what happens, suppose you write something, suppose you write let me just write any word. Suppose I write edge, so I want that to be replaced by a hypothesis maybe. So I type here I hypothesis, and what happens that whenever I type H and I click on enter in my word, it will get replaced with hypothesis. But this is not what I would suggest you all. There are certain words, as you can see, which are there by default in Word. Suppose happen, so it will get changed into happen. So these are certain words which is already there. I would not suggest you all to do this. You can use some, if you want to, like you want to replace MC with Markov chain like that, you can do that, but I would not again suggest you to use this, because this also creates certain problems when you are typing. When you want to type MC, it will get changed into Markov chain, which is not what I want, right? So that is what happens. For the time being, I'm keeping my autocorrect options button okay. I do not generally, also this I would not suggest you all to do, but many students have asked me how to get rid of these red and blue lines. This is how you get rid of it, but again I would not suggest, because in that case what will happen, you will skip the actual spelling mistakes. Suppose even if I make any spelling mistake, suppose I want to write happy and I just write HAPY, okay, so that was there in your autocorrect feature, so it just automatically changed certain word, any certain word. Suppose I want to write Markov and I by mistake I just simply wrote an I instead of O. See, I'm not getting any spelling errors, I'm not getting any red and blue lines. Also here when I wrote, I'm not getting any spelling mistakes now. X k underscore y. See, I'm not getting any red and blue lines. So this is helpful, but also it sometimes it's bad, because you will not get to know certain actual spelling mistakes which you make, right? Moving on to the next thing, what you can do instead of this is that you can add these certain words which you use again and again to your dictionary. So let me just again turn on these. So I'll move on to the proofing. Over here I will again untick these, click on OK, and you get all those lines back. Suppose KX is something which I want to use again and again everywhere, so I will just click on right, I will click here, I will ignore all. If you click on ignore all, everything will be ignored. Every KX, every K underscore X will be ignored if you write it anywhere in this Word document. Okay, so if I write K underscore X, I will not get any error again. So it's for all, wherever I write KX in my document. But when you add it to the dictionary, even if you open a new Word file and you type KY there, K underscore Y there, you will not get an error. But here, but in this case in KX, because I have just ignored it all for this document, when you open a new document and you type K underscore X, you will still get that error. So this was basic. Now split your answers into paragraphs. Do not write big paragraphs. Split it into points. How to give bullet points? Very simple. Suppose I want to make bullet points with these, so I'll just click on this bullet point and you make it into simple bullet points. See, and when you click on enter, you get those bullet points back, right? So this is how you get your bullet points, and it becomes really simple for the examiner also to read your answers, right? We generally say in IFOA that give your answers in forms of bullet. So you can give number bullet as well from here. These are the numericals, number bullets which you give. This is how you give in form of bullets, right? Bullets are very important. Make a lot of use new paragraph. Do not make answers really big paragraph. Do not do that. Give lot of spaces in between. Suppose if you have seen my earlier classes, when I write any notation, when I write any function, formula, anything, using the notations, I always give a lot of space in between. I give a lot of multiplication signs in between. I give a lot of brackets in between. So this is very important to make the examiner understand as to what you are typing. Okay, so moving on, I've showed you all how to use tables. Also, now I'll just quickly wrap up. suppose I want to use certain Greek letters. For that, for the Greek letters, IFOE has stated you can simply type mu. Mu is for the Greek letter mu. You can simply type theta for theta, and you can type gamma. You can type sigma. So you can just simply, instead of using the Greek letters, you can type down these words. If still you want to use mu, theta, sigma, gamma and all those, I will show you all how to get this from the insert tab in the symbols. These are the recently used symbols which I have been using in my past few classes. So it has been already added over here. If you do not have it, just go to the more symbols. Here in the subset, search for Greek and Coptic. Greek and Coptic, here you will get all your Greek letters. So this is your mu, this is your nu, you have your omega, you have your theta, you have your rho, so this is your rho, this is your pi, this is your epsilon. So these are the different Greek letters. See, many Greek letters you will get over here, everything. And you can just click on, suppose you want to select theta, and even search, just click on insert, and see, you will get your theta over here. Also in the symbols, it has been added to my recently used symbols. So it's better that you use at once all the important Greek letters which you want to, and it will be added to your recently used one. But still, they do not want that. IFOE do not want you all to take so much of, you search so much of Greek letters and type it down or write it down or insert it down. They just want you all to write it in form of words. Like, you can just simply write theta, you can just simply write sigma and all, epsilon and all those things, right? This is what they want. Another way also, I'll show you all how to write Greek letters, but that's not so important. Here you can, in the font section, you can use the font symbols. There is something called symbols. You can see, the moment you select font or symbol, whatever you type from your keyboard, see, I've typed P, so P gets converted into pi. When I type M, it gets converted into mu. When I type T, it gets converted into, when I type S, it gets converted into sigma. Similarly, rho, R for rho. This is how you can change your font to symbols, and then you can use the letters from your keyboard simply to get your Greek letters. But again, I would not suggest you, because then it will take a lot of time. You will again and again have to change it back to the normal font. Once also you can do, you can just, once you have written mu, you can copy and paste it again and again. So that can also be done, right? But then again, you will have to change the font. But when you copy it from here, it will not change your font size, because this I have inserted using the symbols. So this will not change my font. These are the quick things which you can do for Greek letters, but I would suggest to go with these, as this is what the IFOE wants you to do. They do not want you to use any Greek letters as such. So the last thing which I want to cover in this video is that header and footer. You have to give header and footer in your examination. Header should contain your ARN. So how to give headers? Just click on insert, and in here you will find header or footer. So you can give your ARN as a header or as a footer. Anything, I would suggest to give it as header. It's up to you. Wherever you want to, I'll just select the very first one, which is very simple. I will type down my ARN. So you can just simply type down your ARN over here. Also, what you can do, suppose when you type your ARN, after this you can also write, suppose this is my CM1 September 2020 paper. So you can write CM1 September 2020. This will appear on every page. So when I click on close header and footer, see, this will appear on every page. You do not have to type it on again and again. All of these things you can keep handy before the exam. So just open a Word document, type down the ARN beforehand, header and footer, and keep your Word document ready so that you, when you get your paper, you start typing your answer. So the key points which I covered in this video were, I told you about different shortcuts, different quick shortcuts. The next thing is, type each answer in a new page, how to use find and replace, headers and footers, subscript, superscript, keep your answers in bullets if you have any theory to be written down completely. Give a lot of spaces, give a lot of multiplication signs, brackets, give the keywords in bold, give every new answer in a new page so that it's good for you also when you are checking. How to switch off the autocorrect spelling and the grammatical mistakes, get rid of those red and blue lines. Use only notations, no usage of mathematical editor, equation editor. How to insert table and word, how to use Greek letters, and how to not use Excel at all. Please do not use Excel at all. So these were the quick takeaways from this video. I will be making more such videos to increase your efficiency. Keep practicing, and all the best. Thank you.